Hello everybody and welcome to my new podcast channel. Today we will start with the Transparency Thursday series and the first episode of my special interview with Adrian and Marte from Desserto. In this part we will talk about durability, environmental impact and the cost and affordability of this incredible material. So enjoy watching and don't miss this special announcement from Adrian and Marte at the end. Welcome to my interview with very special guests, Adrian and Marte, the founders of Desserto. I've been looking forward to this interview for a while because it is amazing what these two incredible entrepreneurs have already done and changed not only in the fashion industry and how they affected it in a sustainable way. Adrian and Marte created an amazing sustainable material called Desserto, which is a plant-based alternative to leather made from cactus. Today, we will focus most on the characteristics of Desserto, as well as its production and manufacturing process. We will answer all your questions I came across on social media. So thank you so much, Adrian, once more for being here, and Marte, of course. I'm really honored having you, as I'm a huge fan of yours, and I think it will be fun today.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
My first question is about durability. So could you compare it to the durability of leather?
Yeah, absolutely. So Desserto is actually very durable in terms of abrasion, tearing, tensile strength. It also has a very long lifespan, which we have gotten from the aging tests.
Yes.
We have a 5 out of 5 level for humidity resistance. Mm-hmm. So the material can perform from automotive, aeronautics, even for jets and for upholstery, footwear, garments. We have many different formulations to tailor-made or custom-made the materials that a final application is going to have. So in that sense, we are able to control how the material is going to behave, and we do the proper adjustments at the laboratory depending on the customer needs. We know that leather, it's very durable because of its natural characteristics, but at the same time, it's susceptible to water spills, humidity, and yeah. So this is one of the great advantages that our material offers, that it handles humidity very well. Thanks to a protein.
Yes, okay. So there's a wide range of industries that could apply and can apply this material. And I know that Desserto has very good chances to substitute leather. And the concern of the of people is what will happen with the unused leather waste as it is a byproduct of animal farming.
Well, non-vegan point of view, it is valid when the leather industry says that what they are doing is to use a byproduct or a residue of the meat industry when they get the skin and they process it for making a product. This is valid when there is not a very vast use of noxious substances like salt, chrome, liquors, and all the toxic chemicals that tanning industry uses.
Yes.
So we know that although that the skin of the animal, of course, is it's organic, from the transportation all the way to the tanning process, it's already affected with all these toxic substances and synthetics and chemicals that ruin the capability of this of this organic material to biodegrade or not to be noxious to the environment. So not to mention all the little control that the tanneries have in managing the water residues, which eventually are released to the environment, harming the environment, animal life, human life, etc.
Yes, yeah, we will talk about tanneries also later. There are some questions about the tanneries. What about the prices? Because we know how much leather, for example, jackets or bags are normally. Will the end products be affordable for the consumers or customers?
Yeah, we did 2 years of research and development of Desserto, and now we are with an industrial equipment, so we can reduce costs, we can reduce prices. Now our prices are in a competitive range of price between synthetics and between animal leather. So we always make more efforts to reduce prices for the public. And now we can say that we are in between both different industries in a competitive price.
Yes, okay. Well, that's amazing because the substitution is easier than when also the prices are lower, and then it's up to the designers which margins they will set.
Also, we know that the designers and small brands, they cannot afford to buy a production line when a material is very new. Most of the times the company asks for an MOQ very big, so they cannot pay for that. So what we do here to help the designers, to help the small and medium brands, we have charged the cost of our own productions to be able to sell in small quantities to everybody. And in this case, now everybody can buy these materials from 1 meter to what the meters they need. So it's a different kind of.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. So it can be easily spread to the world, to the designers, so that we all have the advantage of the materials. If the demand gets much bigger and the material will be produced on a large scale, which I assume it will there be any harms caused to the environment in terms of pesticides, road enhancers, chopping down trees to grow fields of cactus, or extra water usage, or I mean uncontrolled cactus production?
This is a very good question. First of all, when we talk about sustainability, we have to analyze the origin of the feedstocks, taking into account, of course, the land, such as land use change. So yes. Natural feedstocks come from soil, so we have to evaluate that aspect. In our case, we acquired 40 acres of land that were previously pre-owned and used for agricultural processes, such as corn and some other vegetables. These vegetables and the corn and other crops that were grown there had a land use change. Why? Because they had to be planted, harvest, planted, harvest, and this annually. So the soil gets deteriorated. So never mind, of course, the use of fertilizers, pesticides, herbicides. So what we did was to rescue those lands that were previously open for plantations, meaning that there was not cutting trees involved, not deforestation. And in these lands, what we actually did was to regenerate the soil first, to prepare. So how do we do that? We have some news for the next month.
Yeah?
No, next week. We'll have available some new colors for the stock of dessert, so we'll be available for everybody.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to it because I already love my black jacket. And I'm also looking forward for the red one and the green one.
Awesome. We have some very interesting proposals for garments, which are going to be finished out of production this week. Actually, as we are talking, we are just finishing the last batches of production.
Yeah.
And these are very, very nice materials, not just in terms of colors, but also in terms of softness and technological differentiations. So I'm sure that we're going to make sure to send you some swatches.
Yeah, I'm waiting. I can't. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss the next episode. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below and I will gladly get back to you.